top six answers on the board. Give me an ice cream flavor a stripper might use as her stage name.
Chocolate.
Chocolate, yes! Chocolate.
Vanilla.
Vanilla. Pass the point.
We're gonna play.
Adrian, give me an ice cream flavor stripper might use as a stage name.
Butter pecan.
A stripper with a four-syllable name. Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, butter pecan. Butter pecan. Adrian, that must be your favorite ice cream.
It is,
that's
Steve,
mine
I
too,
love
girl.
It.
That's
love
mine
it.
Too. Antoinette, give me an ice cream flavor stripper might use that stage name.
Strawberry.
Strawberry. Anisha, give me an ice cream flavor stripper might use as a stage name.
Cookies and cream.
Cookies and cream. Aaliyah, two strikes. We got to be careful. The Adams family can steal now. Give me an ice cream flavor stripper might use as a stage name.
Birthday cake. Birthday cake. Birthday cake.
I'm just looking at you ladies, and I just know this. You've never been to a strip club. Ladies and gentlemen, birthday cake.
What? Possible.
Nope. Birthday cake. Give me an ice cream flavor stripper might use as her stage name.
Cherry.
Cherry. Six.
Yes.
Five.
Rocky Road.
Top six answers are on the board. In order to be truly happy, you need to have at least one good what? Steve.
Wife.
One good wife, my man.
Okay.
Career. Career.
Career.
All right, let's play. See if we're gonna play.
Hey, Scott, in order to be happy, you need to have at least one good what?
One good friend.
One good friend.
Yeah.
Hey, Sean, in order to be truly happy, you need to have at least one good what?
One good dog.
One good dog. Oh. Sam, in order to be truly happy, you need to have at least one good what?
Oh, bank account?
One good bank. One good bank.
Come on, give it to me. Yeah!
Miss Shirley, in order to be truly happy, you need to have at least one good what?
One good parent.
One good parent.
Yes, baby. Yeah. You're on it. You're on it. You're on it.
Oh. Steve, only one strike. In order to be truly happy, you got to have at least one good what?
Child? I'm the good one, Steve. I'm the good one.
One good child.
Oh!
Hey, Scott, we got two strikes. You gotta be careful. Peterson family can steal. In order to be truly happy, you need to have at least one good what?
Home.
One good home.
It is.
Okay. In order to be truly happy, you need to have at least one good what?
Mentor!
One good mentor!
Mentor! Number five, I don't know. Four. Top six answers on the board. Name an occupation in which you are likely to get wet on the job.
It's lifeguard.
Lifeguard, wow. Pass the point.
Bring it home, baby!
Name an occupation in which you're likely to get wet on the job.
Car wash attendant.
Car wash. CC, name an occupation in which you're likely to get wet on the job.
Nurse.
A nurse. Keontae,
yes, sir.
Name an occupation in which you're likely to get wet on the job.
I work at a water park.
Work at the water park.
Okay.
We got two strikes now, Kai. We got to be careful. My Uber family can steal. Name an occupation in which you're likely to get wet on the job.
A sailor?
Okay. That's good. That's good. A sailor! Pull that one out, didn't you?
That
blew my what they called. A sailor, no.
Papa,
no.
She had a blonde moment.
We got two strikes now, Chate. We got to be careful. The other family can steal. Name an occupation in which you're likely to get wet on the job.
I'm going to say a firefighter.
Firefighter! Carlos, two strikes. The other family can steal, man. Give me an occupation in which you're likely to get wet on the job.
Construction worker.
A construction worker. All right, family, here's your chance. Give me an occupation in which you're likely to get wet on the job.
Steve, we're going to go with fisherman.
Yes.
Fisherman. All right, guys, top six answers on the board. Name a reason you might find a nerd sexy. Monique.
Because he wears glasses.
Because he wears glasses.
Because he's smart, he's gonna make a lot of money.
Because he's smart.
We're gonna play, Steve.
All right. Name a reason you might find a nerd sexy.
He's a sharp dresser.
He's a sharp dresser.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Woo! Hello, Ms. Robin. How are you?
I'm doing well. How are you?
Good to have you. What do you do again?
I'm a retired teacher of 33 years.
Wow.
Yeah.
Well, welcome back. Name
Thank
a reason you.
You
might find a nerd sexy.
Because of his pocket protector.
Yeah.
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 Right here, the pocket protector.
Oh, you talking about that thing they put
yeah.
in there and then they put the pen. Yeah, I ain't never had one of them.
Yeah, yeah.
Uh-huh. Gotta keep them shirt clean.
Because of their pocket protector.
Yeah.
Hey, Jake, how you doing, man?
Doing well, Steve.
Name a reason you might find a nerd sexy.
He drives that nice new Tesla. New
he
car.
Drives a... He drives a nice new Tesla. Oh. Bailey, we got two strikes. We got to be careful now. The other family can steal. Name a reason you might find a nerd sexy.
The way he styles his hair. Yeah.
The way he styles yeah. his hair. You might find a nerd sexy.
Because he wears braces.
Because he wears braces. Number six. Three. Number two. Top seven answers on the board. Name a famous woman who's curvy and confident.
Marilyn Monroe.
Marilyn Monroe.
Diana Ross.
Diana Ross.
We'll play.
We're gonna play. Hey, Delaney. All right, let's play the game. Name a famous woman who's curvy and confident.
J-Lo.
J-Lo. Hello, Megan. How are you?
Good. How are you?
All right, Megan. Name a famous woman who's curvy and confident.
Lizzo.
Lizzo. Eric, name a famous woman who's curvy and confident.
Steve, I'm gonna say Oprah.
Oprah. Bridget, name a famous woman who's curvy and confident.
Dolly Parton.
Dolly Parton. Yeah. Woo! Alan, sir, name a famous woman who's curvy and confident.
Michelle Obama.
Michelle Obama. Delaney, name a famous woman who's curvy and confident.
Beyonce.
Beyonce. One answer, you can clear the board, Megan. Only one strike. Name a famous woman who's curvy and confident.
Megan Thee Stallion.
Megan the Stallion. All right, we got two strikes, Eric. We got to be careful. The Wallace family can steal. Name a famous woman who's curvy and confident.
Steve, I'm gonna say Kim Kardashian.
Yes.
Good answer.
Kim Kardashian. Top four answers on the board. Name something people might do by candlelight. KC.
Dinner.
Dinner. We'll play. Hey, toy, some people might do by candlelight.
Birthday cake.
Birthday cake. Victoria, name something people might do by candlelight.
Camping.
Camping. This is going too fast now, family. Come on, we got two strikes now. If it's there, we're still alive. If it's not there, the other family can steal and win. Tan. Name something people might do by candlelight.
Go hiking.
Go hiking with a candle. The whole force on fire. Let's go hiking. Family, I got three answers. Either answer there, your family steals, your family wins the game. But if it's not there, the win family wins the game. Name something people might do by candlelight.
Have sex, Steve.
This is for the win. Have sex! Number four. Two. Top four answers on the board. Name something a man gets that he loves to show off. Taj.
Car.
Man. Car.
Hey, Steve, we're gonna play.
You're gonna let's go, homie. Angel, name something a man gets that he loves to show off.
His pretty woman.
Hell yeah. Yeah. His pretty woman. Maria, name something a man gets that he loves to show off.
He loves to show off his clothes.
Good answer. Good answer.
His clothes. Eddie, name something a man gets that he loves to show off.
Jewelry, Steve.
Good answer.
Jewelry. Oh. Christine, one answer left. Give me something a man gets that he loves to show off.
I think a man would love to show off his big house.
Good answer.
The big house. Oh. Taj, one answer left. If it's not there, the Callahan family can steal, win the game, and drive away in a brand new car.
A child.
Wow. This is for sudden death. A child! Oh. Folks, we are down to one answer and one answer only. If you give me that one answer, folks, you're going to steal, you're going to win the game, and you're driving out of here in a brand new car. But if it's not there, the other family gets a chance to play sudden death. Name something a man gets that he loves to show off.
A new haircut.
This is for the win and for the brand new car. A new haircut! Number three. Oh. This is on the board. Name something you can see yourself wishing for on your 100th birthday. Jose.
More time.
More time, baby. Just a little more time.
A big piece of cake.
Big piece of cake.
We're gonna play.
Holly, name something you can see yourself wishing for on your 100th birthday.
To die.
To die. Yeah! My man.
Somebody's gotta do it, right?
Yeah.
Somebody's gotta do it.
Name something you can see yourself wishing for on your 100th birthday.
Wish for every hot chick.
Wish for every hot chick!
Yeah!
Oh! Woo! Taya?
Taya. It's all right.
Name something you can see yourself wishing for on your 100th birthday.
Something on my bucket list.
Something on your bucket list. Only one strike, Jesus, my man. Name something you can see yourself wishing for on your 100th birthday.
Grandkids.
Grandkids. Jose, we got two strikes. You gotta be careful, man. Snail family can steal. They good at that too, listen to me. Name something you can see yourself wishing for on your 100th birthday.
A family reunion?
Family reunion! All right, family, name something you can see yourself wishing for on your 100th birthday.
Younger body.
New teeth. New teeth.
Huh?
New teeth.
Some new teeth.
I like that. It's up there. Come on. Come on.
2.
Yeah.
Point values are double, fellas. We got top 6 answers on the board. Name an occupation that the better they look, the more money they make. Keith, model. Kristen, name an occupation that the better they look, the more money they make.
Actor or actress?
Good, good, good.
Actor and actress. Emily, name an occupation that the better they look, the more money they make.
An athlete?
An athlete. Peter, name an occupation, the better they look, the more money they make.
Steve, a stripper.
Samantha, name an occupation, the better they look, the more money they make.
A bartender.
Good answer.
Bartender. Keith, an occupation, the better they look, the more money they make.
I'm gonna say a news anchor.
News anchor. All right, we got 2 strikes. We gotta be careful. The Heisen family can steal.
A trainer? A fitness trainer?
Fitness trainer!
Oh, okay.
That was a good answer. Well, name an occupation TV that the better shows. They look, the more money they make.
A singer.
A singer! Number 6.
Oh, yeah.
Number 5.
Oh, yeah.
Top 6 answers on the board, ladies. We asked 100 men, where's the number one place you are when you think about sex? Tiffany.
In a shower.
In a shower. Pass the play.
We're gonna play.
Bedroom home. TG. TG, we talked to 100 men. Where's the number one place you are when you think about sex?
The strip club.
At the strip club! When I'm letting them dollars go, strip club! Joshua, where's the number one place you are when you think about sex?
While he's at work.
While he's at work. Work. Yes, it is. Miss Tony, where is the number one place these men are when they... they just make me sick. When they think about sex, Miss Tony.
Driving.
Hell yeah, driving. Driving. Taylor, we talked to 100 men. Where's the number one place you are when you think about sex?
Your wedding.
It's your wedding. Tiffany.
Yes.
2 strikes.
All right.
Other family can steal. Where's the number one place you are when you think about sex?
On your date. On a date.
On a date. Oh. All of these are good answers. All of these are good answers. Chad, we talked to 100 men. Where's the number one place you are when you think about sex?
Well, just like you said, Steve, anywhere and everywhere.
Anywhere and everywhere. Number 3.
Bar-mitzvah.
Top 6 answers on the board. Name a woman's sport where the players are tougher than the average guy. Crystal.
Football.
Football. Jordan.
Soccer.
Soccer. Jake, name a women's sport where the players are tougher than the average guy.
I'm going to say basketball.
Basketball. Hello, Miss Deb. Give me a women's sport where the players are tougher than the average guy.
I'm going to say tennis.
Tennis. Tennis. Tracy, give me a women's sport where the players are tougher than the average guy.
Volleyball, Steve.
Volleyball. Hey, Joe, give me a sport. You're a coach, right?
I sure am.
Okay. You teach boys or girls?
I teach boys baseball.
Boys baseball, okay. Here's a coach, folks. Here we go. Guy that works with boys in athletics. Gonna be an interesting answer. Name a woman's sport where the players are tougher than the average guy.
Well, I'm gonna say the opposite of my boys and say softball girls.
Girl softball. Your players won't be speaking to you after that one, Coach. We got two strikes Herbert family can steal. Jordan, name a women's sport where the players are tougher than the average guy.
Lacrosse, Steve.
Huh?
Lacrosse.
Lacrosse! Name a women's sport where the players are tougher than the average guy.
We're gonna go with track and field.
Woo. Track and field. Six.
Hockey.
Five.
Rugby.
Two. Top six answers on the board. We ask 100 men, tell me the sexiest thing to watch a woman eat.
A hot dog.
A hot dog.
Chicken wing.
Chicken wing. Chicken wing. Kennedy.
I'm gonna say chocolate covered strawberries.
Oh, yeah.
Chocolate covered strawberries. Steven.
I'm gonna say spaghetti.
Spaghetti?
Yep.
Wow.
Slurping.
Spaghetti.
Oh my gosh.
Let's play.
We're gonna play. Okay.
Kennedy, what do you do?
Well, I am a rising senior studying strategic communications at Hampton University, the real HU.
Well, that's pretty good. Quenisha, how are you?
I am great.
Good. What do you do?
I am a graduate of the Alabama State University.
Hornets.
Amen. Yes.
Well, welcome to the show.
Thank you.
All right, Quenisha, here we go. We ask 100 men, tell me the sexiest thing to watch a woman eat.
Let's say soup.
All right, here we go. Talk to 100 men. Tell me the sexiest thing to watch a woman eat.
I'm gonna say pineapples.
Pineapples. We gotta be careful now, Kenya. We got two strikes, darling. And the other family can steal. Talk to 100 men. Tell me the sexiest thing to watch a woman eat.
A banana.
Please. Number one, banana. Taisha, two strikes, gotta be careful. 100 men, tell me the sexiest thing to watch a woman eat.
Probably a lollipop.
Lollipop. All right, family, we got four men over here. Four men, we don't get this right. 100 men, four of them right here. Tell me the sexiest thing to watch a woman eat.
I'm gonna say a popsicle, Steve.
Popsicle. Good answer. Number six. Five.
Thinking that too.
Four.
Cucumber.
Top four answers on the board. Name a sport where the men have bigger bottoms than most women. Allison.
Football.
Football.
Wrestling.
Wrestling. I got you. David, how you feeling today, man?
I'm feeling good, Uncle Steve.
All right, name a sport where the men have bigger bottoms than most women.
Basketball.
Good answer. Good answer. Good answer. Good
answer. Good answer. Joe, give me a sport where the men have bigger bottoms than most women.
Swimming.
Swimming. We have a situation here now, Angela. Mm-hmm. If it's there, we're still alive. But this time, you got two strikes. If it's not there, the Moore family can steal and win the game. Mm-hmm. So, Angela, name a sport where the men have bigger bottoms than most women.
Hockey.
Good answer.
Good answer. Hockey. Well, family, here's the situation I got two answers on the board. If you give me either one of those answers, your family steals, your family wins the game. But if it's not there, the Ahuna family wins the game. This is it right here. This decides the game. Name a sport where the men have bigger bottoms than most women.
Baseball.
This is for the win. Baseball. I have no idea. Number four.
What's
a good answer?
Ice
skating.
What? Three.
Weightlifting.
Top four answers on the board. Which U.S. state has the craziest people? Truman.
New York.
New York. Yeah.
California.
We're going to play, Steve.
We're going to play. Yeah. Eric,
yes,
what
sir.
U.S. state has the craziest people?
Florida, sir.
Florida. One answer left. Miss Carroll, you give me that answer, you clear the board. Your family wins this game. If it's not there, you're still alive, you have no strikes. Which U.S. state has the craziest people?
Alabama.
That's really good
answer.
Alabama. Alabama. Mike, one answer left. If it's there, your family wins the game. If it's not there, you're still alive, only one strike. Which U.S. state has the craziest people?
I'm going to say Texas, Steve.
Good answer. Good answer.
This is for the win, Texas. Top four answers on the board. Name a tool that a handyman might nickname his package.
Hammer.
Hammer. Chandler.
Yes, sir.
Give me a tool that a handyman might nickname his package.
Let's go with a screwdriver, Steve.
Yeah. Yes, screwdriver. Carla, name a tool that a handyman might nickname his package.
Wrench, Steve.
The big wrench.
Big Adams.
Renaud, name a tool that a handyman might nickname his package.
I'm gonna go with a nail gun.
Okay. Oh, yeah.
Nail gun! Ryan, I got one answer left. You give me that one answer, your family wins the game. Yes, name a tool that a handyman might nickname his package.
I'm gonna go with the yardstick.
Oh, yeah. You feel me? You feel me? Yes, sir. It's up there.
This is for the win.
Come on.
The yardstick. Jasmine,
yes.
I got one answer left. If it's there again, your family wins the game. But this time you have two strikes. If it's not there, the other family can steal and they will win the game. Name a tool that a handyman might nickname his package.
A saw, Steve.
This is for the win. A saw! All right, family, here's the situation. I got one answer only. If you give me that one answer, your family steals, your family wins the game. But if it's not there, the Adams family wins the game. This decides it all right here. Name a tool that a handyman might nickname his package.
His drill.
This is for the win. His drill. Top four answers on the board. If People magazine had a sexiest president no longer alive issue, who'd be on the...
JFK.
JFK.
Pass the point. We're gonna play, Steve.
Brett, People magazine had a sexiest president no longer alive issue, who'd be on the cover?
Thomas Jefferson.
Thomas Jefferson. And if People magazine had a sexist president no longer alive issue, who'd be on the cover?
Bill Clinton.
I don't know.
Oh, he's alive. Oh, damn. He's alive.
Poor Bill Clinton.
Fair enough. Fair enough. My bad, man.
All right, two strikes. Come on now, if it's there, we're still alive. If it's not there, the other family can steal and win.
Abe Lincoln.
Ooh, good one.
Abe Lincoln! Amy, two strikes. People magazine has sexist president no longer alive issue. Who'd be on the cover?
Steve, there's something sexy about being first, so I'm gonna say George Washington.
George Washington, probably because he owned the money. Well, Allie, we got one answer left. You can clear the board. If it's there, your family wins the game.
I'm gonna say John Adams.
John Adams! Family, I got one answer. You give me that one answer, your family steals, your family wins the game.
Come on.
People magazine had a sexist president no longer live issue. Who'd be on the cover?
Ronald Reagan.
Ronald Reagan! Top four answers on the board. Name something you'd hate to forget on your wedding day. Kimmy.
Your vows.
Your vows.
A ring.
A ring.
Well done.
They don't play. Christopher, something you'd hate to forget on your wedding day.
A condom, Steve.
Your condoms. Your condoms! Joe, J-O, give me something you'd hate to forget on your wedding day.
I did this. Clothes.
Forgot your clothes.
I forgot some clothes.
Ray Dean, listen to me. I got one answer left. You give it to me, you win. But you only have one strike. If it's not there, you're still alive.
Okay.
Name something you hate to forget on your wedding day.
The address to the church.
The address to the church! One answer left. You give it to me, you win. But this time, you have two strikes. If it's not there, the other family can steal, and they will win.
Your new spouse's name.
I would hate that. You forget your new spouse's name.
I hate that.
Top four answers on the board. Tell me a U.S. city that has a lot of millionaires.
New York City.
New York City. She's gonna play. Carol, give me a U.S. city that's got a lot of millionaires.
L.A.
L.A.
Yeah!
Miss Barbara, tell me a U.S. city that has a lot of millionaires.
Miami?
Yes!
Miami! Christine, one answer left. If it's there, your family wins the game. If it's not there, you're still alive, no strikes. Christine, give me a U.S. city that has a lot of millionaires.
Chicago.
Good answer. Good answer.
Chicago. Kevin, only one strike. If it's there, partner, your family wins the game. But if it's not, you're still alive. A U.S. city that has a lot of millionaires.
San Francisco,
wow.
Steve.
Yes.
Wow. This is for the win. San Francisco. I thought that was the answer. Caitlin, you got one answer left. If it's there, your family wins the game, but this time you got two strikes. If it's not there, the other family can steal and they will win the game. Caitlin, give me a U.S. city that's got a lot of millionaires.
Atlanta.
They got a lot of them. Atlanta! Well, family, here we go. I got one answer only. If it's there, your family steals, your family wins the game. But if it's not there, the other family wins the game. This decides it. Winner take all. Here we go. Tell me a U.S. city that has a lot of millionaires.
Steve, we're gonna say Las Vegas.
Yeah, good answer.
Las Vegas! Number three. Top four answers on the board. Name a place a man goes to celebrate his divorce. Kira.
The bar, Steve.
The bar.
Steve, we just don't play.
I'm gonna know all of these. Mia, name a place a man goes to celebrate his divorce. I'll tell you right away.
His side chick's house.
I'm on the way over. The side chick's house. Name a place a man goes to celebrate his divorce.
A casino, Steve.
Casino. answer left, Alana. Name a place a man goes to celebrate his divorce.
He's going to the car dealership to buy a new car and celebrate.
Buy a car! Rini, one answer left. You give me that answer, your family wins the game.
The gym.
The gym! Kira,
yes.
One answer left. You give me that one answer, your family wins the game. But this time, you have two strikes. If it's not there, the other family can steal, and they will win the game. Name a place a man goes to celebrate his divorce.
I'm gonna say with his friends. He's gonna hang out with his friends, Steve.
Hang out with his friends! All right, family, here's the situation. I've got one answer left and one answer only. If you give me that one answer, your family steals, your family wins the game. If it's not there, the other family wins the game. This decides it, winner take all, here we go. Name a place a man goes to celebrate his divorce.
We're gonna go with the strip club.
Go right down there. This is for the win. Strip club! Top four answers on the board. Here we go. Name something that comes in pairs of two because just one would be useless.
Shoes.
Shoes. You better know it. That's a great answer.
We're gonna play these.
Donna, name something that comes in pairs of two because one would just be useless.
Socks.
Socks.
Yeah!
Daniel, name something that comes in pairs of two because one just would be useless, man.
Roller skates.
You have no idea how many times I went to the store with one roller skate. Everyone, one roller skate.
I have the other one.
We still going with it, baby. Roller skates. Hey, Steve, we only got one strike. Come on now. Name something that comes in pairs of two, because just one would be just useless.
Gloves.
Come on now. Gloves. Lindsay, listen to me. Got one answer left.
Okay.
You give me that one answer. Your family is playing sudden death.
Okay.
Name something that comes in pairs of two, because just one would be useless.
I'm gonna go with earrings, Steve.
Yeah! Earrings! Hey, Casey. Again, I got one answer left. Come on now. You give me this one answer, your family plays sudden death.
I'm gonna go with cufflinks.
That's a true statement. Cufflinks! All right, family. I got one answer left and one answer only. You give me that one answer, your family steals. Your family wins this game. But if it's not there, the other family gets a chance to play sudden death. It's the last one. Name something that comes in pairs of two because just one would be useless.
Skis, Steve.
Skis for the win! Number four. Top four answers on the board. Name something specific a woman might do if she wanted a better booty. Melanie.
Squat.
Squats.
We're gonna play.
We're gonna play. Mr. Paul, something specific a woman might do if she wanted a better booty.
I'm gonna say plastic surgery.
Plastic surgery.
Yeah.
Miss Katie, tell me something that a woman might do if she wanted a better booty.
Gain weight.
Gain some weight. Get some weight. You want it? You can get it. Double up on the ham sandwiches. Gain yourself some weight. Hey, Paige, only one strike. Tell me something specific a woman might do if she wanted a better booty.
Diet.
Diet. Hey, Matt, listen to this. I got one answer left, Matt. You give me that answer, your family wins the game. If it's not there, you're still alive, Matt. Only one strike. Name something specific a woman might do if she wanted a better booty.
She might wear inserts, like those slide-up shorts with the inserts.
Hey, hey, put you some of them inserts in. Slide on some inserts. Top four answers on the board. Name a reason a couple might be in a hurry to get married.
She's pregnant.
She's pregnant.
Do we want to play? Yes.
Yeah, we're going to
play.
Yes, ma'am. Hey, Don, give me a reason a couple be in a hurry to get married.
Because they're deeply in love.
Because they're deeply in love. Brandy, give me a reason that a couple might be in a hurry to get married.
One of them might be getting deployed, Steve.
Oh, good
one. One of them might be getting deployed.
Okay.
Hey, Jen, only one strike. Give me a reason a couple might be in a hurry to get married.
Maybe because one's getting deported.
Oh, yes.
About to get deported. Well, Michelle, we got one answer left. You give me that one answer, your family gonna win the game. But if it's not there, you are still alive, only one strike. Give me a reason a couple might be in a hurry to get married.
Because their parents don't want them to.
Yes.
Because their parents don't want them to. All right, now, Miss Nancy, we got one answer left. You give it to me, your family wins the game. But this time, you got two strikes. If it's not there, the other family can steal and play sudden death. Miss Nancy, name a reason a couple might be in a hurry to get married.
I think because they're getting too old.
Oh, good answer.
So they want to get married because they're running out of time. Why not? If I was 90, I'd think, oh, I want to get married before I, you know.
Yeah, you ain't got no waiting period. Pretty much got to go now. Yeah. Getting old! Top seven answers on the board. If the punishment fits the crime, what's the punishment for cheating on your spouse? Ms. Shirley.
Divorce.
Divorce. Sam, how you doing, man?
I'm doing all right. How are you?
Welcome back to the show.
Good to be here.
All right, Sam, if the punishment fits the crime, what's the punishment for cheating on your spouse?
It hurts to say castration.
Good answer. Good answer.
Castration! What's all the extra laughing about? Darren, how you doing, man?
Not too bad, Steve.
All right, here we go. If the punishment fits the crime, what's the punishment for cheating on your spouse?
The other gets to cheat, too.
Yeah!
All the other one gets to cheat, too. appreciate it. If the punishment fits the crime, what's the punishment for cheating on your spouse?
I'm not as harsh, so I'm gonna say sleeping on the couch.
Sleep on the couch. Hey, Dan, we only got one strike, man. Punishment fits the crime. What's the punishment for cheating on your spouse?
Blast it to social media.
Blast it on social media. We've got two strikes now, Miss Shirley. We gotta be careful. The McKellum family can steal. If the punishment fits the crime, what's the punishment for cheating on your spouse?
I would cry.
You would cry. And if somebody made you cry, Miss Shirley, there's some rather large men in your family that would go and harm them.
Yes.
Better not make Miss Gigi cry. If the punishment fits the crime, what's the punishment for cheating on your spouse?
All right, Steve, we're gonna go with hold back the sex.
Good answer.
Hold back the sex.
It's up there. Yeah!
Number seven.
Let's go. Every STD.
All of them? Number six. Three. Top seven answers on the board. Name something every game show host needs to have.
A microphone.
Microphone.
A smile. A nice smile.
We're gonna play.
We're gonna play. Well, Katie, here we go. Give me something every game show host needs to have.
I'm gonna go with a good suit.
A good suit. Scott, Claire, come on. Name something every game show host needs to have.
An audience.
An audience. And I, Scott, happen to have a great one today. Miss Presley, name something every game show host needs to have.
A great personality.
A great personality. All right, man, let's go. Name something every game show host needs to have.
A bald host. There you go. There you go, Steve.
I love it.
A beautiful bald head, baby. Come on.
A bald host.
I like it. You got to have it. It's up there now.
That's right. As a matter of fact, that was a damn good answer. I don't know why that is.
See?
We got one strike, Rachel. Name something every game show host needs to have.
I'm going to say some makeup. Yeah. Like touch up, you know, a little.
Good answer. Good answer.
Some blemishes, you know.
It's up there.
So what you trying to say, though?
I'm not saying you necessarily. Well, that's true. It's your good.
Who else up here is the game show host?
I mean, everyone can improve.
If you're not talking about me, who are you talking about? It said, name something every game show host need to have. You look dead at me and went, well, show gonna need that makeup.
Makeup.
Come on, Katie. We got two strikes. We got to be careful now. The Russell family can steal. Katie?
I'm gonna go with a studio.
A studio! Name something every game show host needs to have.
Contestants.
Gotta have contestants. Number four.
Sultry voice.
Top seven answers on the board. Name the best excuse to leave a party early.
Not
Not feeling well.
Not feeling well.
We're gonna play, Steve.
Lisa, give me the best excuse to leave a party early.
I would say that you have to get home to your kids.
Have to get home to the kids. Jennifer, give me the best excuse to leave a party early.
You're tired.
I'm tired. Scott, name your best excuse to leave a party early.
You're drunk.
You're drunk. Bob, name your best excuse to leave a party early.
You have a meeting the next day, and you have to get... You gotta
got a meeting the next day. Bob's business guy. You gotta go to a meeting.
Yeah!
Kristen, name your best excuse to leave a party early.
You have another party or another event to go to after.
Wow.
Whoa.
Very popular, Steve.
Got another party to get to. Oh. All right, now, Lisa, we got two strikes. We got to be careful. The child's family can steal. Lisa, name your best excuse to leave a party early.
Let's say you don't get along with someone. You have an argument with someone at the party.
You have an argument with somebody at the party. Oh. All right, family, name your best excuse to leave a party early.
The party's boring, Steve. That's why we want to leave. That's our excuse. The party is boring.
The party is boring. Number six.